The songwriting lesson and the songwriting with parameters lesson are very closely tied together. If you're teaching songwriting with parameters, you can teach songwriting first to refresh everybody's memory, and then it should all flow the way you're about to see in the video. If you're only teaching songwriting, go ahead and skip the second part, but it's very possible that someone will ask about differences in choruses, and then you can go ahead and teach them the parameters part as well. Okay, so how many of you have ever looked up lyrics to any song? All right, so you're probably used to having them written down, yeah. Something like this. Mm-hmm. So has anybody ever heard this song before? Ideally, this would be a song that you guys kind of know, but it sounds like the majority of you guys don't know the song. So I'm going to teach you the chorus, okay? So the chorus, have any of you heard of the chorus of a song? When you're looking up lyrics, you have the chorus of a song, right? So the chorus goes, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut. Can you guys do that with me?
I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut.
Okay, that was very good. So now we're going to take it from here. Here we go.
I'm a little acorn brown, sitting on the cold, cold ground. Everybody sits on me, that is why I'm cracked, you see. I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut. I found myself a telephone, just to see if I was home. Asked myself out on a date, picked me up at 8:30. I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut. Took myself to the picture show. Sat myself in the very first row, wrapped my arms around my waist, got so fresh I slapped my face.
I'm a nut, I'm a nut,
I'm a nut, I'm a nut, I'm a nut.
Say what?
Okay, very good. All right, so we went through the lyrics. Why, when it said chorus here, why didn't you sing, that is why I'm cracked, you see, chorus?
Yeah. Because chorus, it means so like after you don't say chorus, you just go to a different one, and then you go back to the one below chorus, and then you sing it, and then it says chorus, and then you do it again.
Okay, so what you're saying is that we are singing all this because it's written down, but when we say chorus, we're really referring back to this thing we already defined earlier, right? We gave this thing a name. And that name was?
Chorus.
And so now, anytime we wanted to use this chunk, instead of writing it all over and over and over again, all we had to do is put the word?
Chorus.
Very good. Yes?
Like, each of those, like, paragraphs are the verses. So if you know the song really well, you could just do, like, verse, chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus.
So you could take verse one and define it over here. Take verse 2 and define it over here, and verse 3 over here, and then you'd write your program by saying verse 1, chorus, verse 2, chorus, verse 3, chorus. Very good. All right? Does everybody get how you define a chorus and use it later? Okay. So now you guys are saying, well, what if something's kind of different, right? What if something's a little different in the chorus and we want to call with one thing and then with another thing? We could just make two different choruses. All there really is in Old MacDonald is choruses. Yeah. You just sing the same chorus over and over, but you have to change the words. So if you were going to sing Old MacDonald with all your favorite animals, you'd have to have 12 different choruses, right? That wouldn't save you any writing. In fact, it might be more writing than you need. So what we're doing is we're introducing something called a parameter. Can you guys say parameter?
Parameter?
Parameter. So you probably have noticed the word parameter on our word wall.
Yes.
But this is what it actually means. It's an extra little bit of information that you want to pass through so that you know what to sing in the chorus, because it can change in the chorus. So here, we're gonna have animal. So on his farm he had an animal. Yeah. But are we actually going to sing animal?
No, we're going to look at the chorus over there, which is pig, so we're going
to
sing pig.
We need to know which animal we're going to substitute for the word animal. And then whatever's first, because animal is first, whatever's first is going to become animal. And whatever second is going to become
sound.
Very good. So let's try this. Let's try singing the song exactly the way it's written.
Okay.
Chorus pig, oink, chorus cow moo, chorus chicken bawk. Is that really what they meant for me to say?
Chorus chicken bawk.
No. So what I want you to do, now that you understand the definition, when it's called with its parameters, I want you to see if your brain automatically knows what you're actually supposed to sing. Okay? Here's your test. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Old MacDonald had a farm.
E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a pig. E-I-E-I-O. With an oink oink here and an oink oink there. Here, yeah, oink, there, oink, everywhere, oink, oink. Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. Buck here and a buck, buck there. Here a buck, there a buck, everywhere a buck, buck. Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O.
Oh, good job, guys. So what were some things you noticed? After you were done going all the way through, it called chorus. So you went all the way through chorus, and then what did you do?
We repeated it, but switched the word to cow and then chicken.
You went to the next line down in the program, right?
Yeah.
And then you did it again. And then you went to the next line down in the program. And you did it again. And then you got back and there was nothing left in the program, so you
stopped.
End of the line. So that's exactly what a computer does when you have a function, and there's a function that you've defined somewhere else, and you said, hey, whenever I say this word, I really want you to go do all this stuff. So I'm only going to type this because I got better things to do. But you are going to run all of this. Oh, and because it changes a lot, I'm just going to let you know what I want these special words to become. So all I have to do is this. And you're gonna do all the work for me.
Yay!
That's functions with parameters. Okay?
But how does a computer know to say that? Don't you have to program it to say that?
But we don't have to, because a computer inside just a computer's programming, it understands, it's already been told that these are the way we tell you things later. So we don't have to do that as part of this one program, because the master program that makes the computer run at all has already told it. That's a really good question.